This is the End Zone. We're breaking down Arizona State in the Pac-12 South. Herm Edwards, one of my favorite coaches in college football, returns to the Pac-12 with a solid NFL-influenced unit. I'm actually going to make a video about his philosophy pretty soon that is trending upward as a program. The Sun Devils are only a couple steps away from being the number one team, in my opinion, in the Pac-12 South. And last season, they were able to take down Oregon after losing four straight games. I think that Arizona State is a year or two away from becoming an elite program in college football. In the offseason, Herm Edwards hired Zach Hill from Boise State to boost an offense that was 96th in the country in scoring and abysmal in the red zone, taking too many field goals. The plan is to mold the scheme around freshman sensation Jaden Daniels. On defense, a familiar face, Marvin Lewis, joins Antonio Pierce as they plan to move the defense to a 4-3 scheme. I love the addition of Marvin Lewis. Been retired for a while, was actually an analyst for the Alliance of American Football, and is now back on the football field as a defensive coordinator. Now let's take a look at some of the key losses for Arizona State. Not too many of them, but they were very big. Eno Benjamin, running back star. Brandon Ayuk, one of those guys who you could just throw a screen to and let him do the rest. And then Kobe Williams, your cornerback, mostly losing guys on offense as the defense is actually really stacked this year. So with that being said, let's look at the offense. The weakness of this team is the offensive consistency. There wasn't much of it last year. They only averaged about 24.8 points per game, which is what coincidentally an average NFL team scores per game. Like I said, this is kind of an NFL college program. You got quarterback Jaden Daniels returning. He completed 60% of his passes, 2,943 total yards, 17 touchdowns, and get this, just 2 interceptions. With 355 rushing yards and 3 touchdowns, this guy showed up Justin Herbert on a national stage and was extremely accurate for a freshman quarterback. I can't wait to see the strides that he's going to take as a sophomore. At running back, it's never a good sign when your quarterback leads the team in returning rushing yardage, but that is the case for the Sun Devils. It looks like they're going to rely on freshman Demonte Trainum. He is a 220-pound, 5'11", 4-star out of Ohio. He was recruited heavily by a bunch of Big Ten schools, including Penn State and Ohio State. I expect him to be a breakout guy for this offense. Herm Edwards is not afraid to start freshmen, and I'm excited to see him play. At wide receiver, you got Frank Darby returning, averaging about 20 yards per catch last season, and he had 8 touchdowns. And he is the guy, wide receiver number one for this offense, but it looks like another freshman, Elijah Badger, will also get a starting role in the offense. Like I said, one of the things we're seeing is your age doesn't really matter for Herm Edwards. He's going to start you even if you're a freshman. If you've got the talent, he will get you in the game. As for the offensive line, the line will see some massive upgrades via the transfer portal. They both land on the left side, while Donovan West and Ladarius Henderson highlight the right side. From what I saw on tape, this offensive line needs a lot of work, especially in the red zone, but I think that having a new offensive coordinator will help a ton, and Herm Edwards should assess that in the offseason. As for the defense, State returns with the 26th best rush defense in the nation, but 115th in the past. So two drastic statistics there. From that stat line alone, you can tell what the Sun Devils need to improve on. Still, they only allow 22 points per game, which is very impressive. The defensive line is a unit that is very strong. Jeremy Lowell returns with 6.5 sacks at defensive tackle, and the addition of freshman Amari Johnson is expected to take a huge impact for this defensive line. At linebacker, Darren Butler leads the team in returning tackles with 44 and is primed for a standout junior season. The linebacker core is very seasoned, so that is a very good sign for Arizona State. As for the secondary consists of 3 seniors and 1 junior. They are experienced and talented, but we need to see them make some steps. They need to improve. My favorite player is cornerback Chase Lucas. But the secondary needs to step up as a whole after allowing 268 yards per game through the air. Now let's take a look at this Arizona State schedule. The consensus for most analysts is that Arizona State will go 8-4, but I think that with this talent and with this schedule, if the offense can improve, you could very easily see a 2-loss season. So let's run through this schedule for Arizona State. Starting off the year with Northern Arizona, UNLV, and BYU. Arizona State is going to start 3-0. I can't see them losing any of these games. BYU doesn't have a shot. It's also at home. Your only away game at UNLV. So they're going to get a nice start to the season. 3-0. Then the hype for Herm Edwards and Jaden Daniels is going to start. Then you travel September 26th to USC. This is a game that I think USC's high-powered offense is just too much for Arizona State to keep up. They really need to take strides offensively. I think that this game will be a loss for Arizona State. Then on October 3rd, they host Oregon State. This should be a redemption game from last year where they lost by 1 point. Then October 10th, UCLA. This is a game that scares me as a potential loss just because of UCLA's offense. You know, I think that Arizona State really needs to take steps forward as an offense, and they're going to need to do it if they can catch up with Chip Kelly and his high-powered offense behind Dorian Thompson-Robinson. And then October 24th, they travel to Colorado. That should be a win. October 31st at Washington State. We really don't know what to expect from Washington State changing to a run-and-shoot Hawaii-styled offense from the air raid, but we should expect a high-powered offense, so that could be a scary game. Then you have probably the hardest stretch of the season, a two-game stretch, or possibly three, depending on how you feel about Utah. November 7th, hosting Cal. I think that they get a loss here. California looks to be a really strong team defensively and offensively. Then November 13th at Oregon. This is going to be a tough, tough game. Oregon's defensive and offensive lines are not a joke, and I think that they're going to be too much for Arizona State. Then November 21st, you finish that stretch with Utah. I don't think that Utah is going to be very good this year, so I think that Arizona State gets the win here, and you finish out the season with a rivalry game at Arizona. Kevin Sumlin on the hot seat. A lot of things are going bad and backwards for Arizona. So I think that you get the win there, and the Arizona State Sun Devils take a step forward from 2019, finishing 9-3 in the Pac-12 South. After looking at the 2020 schedule, you know, the strength really isn't there. You're missing Michigan State from last year, so that strength of schedule, especially out of conference, severely goes down. I can't see Arizona State losing more than 4 or 5 games. I think that they lose 3 and they have a successful regular season heading into bowl play. I'd love to know what you think down below about Arizona State, and tell me what teams you want to see next. Thanks for watching the End Zone. Make sure to like, subscribe, and comment so we can move the chains.